Yo, what is up, front lines is terrible. Oh my god. Anyway, today's video we will cover everything that is wrong with front lines. I will share with you the latest news about front lines and other products coming up from Wargaming, as well as some of the stats that I've collected in the first 3-4 days of front lines that I've played so far, and I'll share with you the stats that I've come up with and why I'm hating front lines so much. But right now, let's get to the game first. First of all, remember to subscribe and set your notification on. Follow this channel, especially if you're here for the mod pack videos. You will get a notification every time a new video comes up, and you will be up to date. I update the mod pack fairly quickly, so it's quite fresh. Anyway, I'm in alpha and we're attacking. I like being aggressive here and going up this valley, this road here, and I like to shoot those guys because you can actually get here before the enemy does. So if you're aggressive, you can actually get here before the enemy does, unless they bum rush you with two or three projectors. It's very difficult for them to completely eliminate you. So I like being aggressive, coming out here early, try to get the early damage, and then take a little bit of damage myself. And once I've taken some damage, I normally run away, go back to my base and top up my HP, and then go into the cap. That's how I normally play in alpha. But the new meta, to be honest with you, most people, the way they're doing it right now is the guys in alpha and bravo are combining. They are both going into the bravo cap circle, the bravo objective, and capping out. I see a lot of people doing that nowadays. Even if when they're spawning in alpha, they drive all the way to bravo to join them to cap, because they know that that's the easiest objective to cap out. So a lot of people are doing that nowadays, which is resulting in very quick games, and which is one of my complaints, which is why I'm hating this game mode at the moment. But I will get to the statistics a bit later. Right now we are watching me being aggressive and trying to kill off these two guys and clearing this area. Now once this area is cleared, once we've killed that T28, which is already gone, and this STA, all the time I'm shooting them, I'm always trying to keep them tracked in their position so that my teammates can help me out, either from the flank or right next to me, and my job is done. I've lost only a little bit of HP. We've managed to kill two guys. I don't know if I got the kills or not, but anyway, I'm satisfied. Now I see the opportunity to go into the cap right now, because we've cleared out this side of the flank. That means there's no one on this side, which is why I'm taking the shortcut and going into the cap from this side. Now normally you don't drive out on this side, because if you drive out from this side, you will get shot out from the guys from where I was, and you will get yourself killed almost instantly. But I cleared them off myself. I'm not even going to bother to top up my HP, because the opportunity is now. Time to pressure the cap. Look at these heavies. They're not even paying attention. They're just sitting there doing nothing. They could have paid attention. I cleared that side, they could have driven into the cap and capped it out. Instead, I've got to make the plays. But hopefully I will be making this play and encouraging them to join me in the cap. So hopefully you know, maybe they are new to this game, they are new to this game mode, so sometimes you can't blame them. You don't know what their status is. They could be, you know, they could be 50,000 games in and still have no clue how to play this game, or they could be brand new players, just bought some premium tanks and decided to play this game mode. I don't know, but anyway, they've decided to come join me in the cap, so that's a good thing. Now two artilleries fired there at me, and I know they're firing from that side, which is why I drove to this side and tried to hide. The heavy tank that was covering the western side was already killed, so I'm going to be safe from the western side. He's not going to be able to shoot me because he's dead, so I'm going to hide here and be arty safe and try to get all the cap XP that I can. Now I've lost a bit of HP. I can't afford to get artillery strike, but thank goodness we managed to cap them out. And I've got a lot of the capture points here. So what I'm going to do is try to drive forward get to the repair station, get myself topped off, keep pushing forward and see if I can spot some of the enemies trying to run away. Now, I'm going to share with you some of the stats that I've collected and why I'm really pissed off with this game. But first of all, let's get on with some news. In episode 7, they're already testing this out on Common Test Server. There's going to be frontline boosters for episode 7. You can buy these boosters for gold. You can buy a pack of one booster for 1 hour. I don't know how much gold they're going to sell it for. You can buy a pack of 3 boosters, 1 hour boosters, or you can buy a pack of 6 1 hour boosters, and they are all 100% XP boosters, which means if you are general in this game, like I'm going to be, I get 1200 XP, right? If I use these boosters and turn them on, I'm going to get double. I'm going to get 100% XP more, which means 1200 XP for general is going to become 2400 XP. This is coming on episode 7. They're testing it out in Common Test Server right now, so look out for it. They're going to sell it for gold. I don't know how much for gold. I suppose you can buy one booster, which is cheap. 3 boosters, it's going to be 3 times the price, but of course they will give you a discount when you buy in bulk. And I think, of course, the 6-pack is what you're going to be searching for, because the 6-pack is going to help you boost up your XP a lot quicker. And those guys that are far behind in your XP, if you're still in Prestige 4 or Prestige 5, you need to catch up to earn the Emil 1 and the AE Phase 2. It's going to be time for you to buy gold with gold those boosters and try and catch up. But you still have to grind through front lines, which is still a pain in the butt, and I'm going to tell you why. Oh yeah, before I continue with the news, before I continue with the front line stats, there is also the UK light tanks that are going to be debuting in 1.6 update, which is coming soon. They're being tested on the Common Test servers now. Now, I haven't made a video in about 1 week, and this is the reason why. I actually recorded videos for the British light tanks, but I didn't have anything positive to say about the tier 8, tier 9 and tier 10 light tanks, which is why I decided not to upload those videos. They were all negative videos, and just as well, everyone, all the YouTubers, Twitch streamers that make videos, nobody had anything positive to say about those British light tanks. And it's not to say that they're completely terrible, but they were certainly not competitive tanks. They were not unplayable. They were playable. They were a challenge. If you enjoy, you know, that kind of sadomasochistic challenge, and if you want to play in those kind of difficult tanks, yes, it is a challenge, it is a difficult tank. They're not impossible to play, but they were not like super enjoyable to play, to be honest with you, which is why I skipped out completely on those videos, and that is why I did not make a video for the last week. But here I am complaining about front lines. I didn't want to make this a negative video, but it is what it is, so let's get on with it. Front lines, a lot of people are hating it at the moment. Look at this Kainabaron Action X. He is full HP. He is a heavy tank. He should be protecting me. I have half HP. He should be on the outside and not on the inside of the cap circle. And if you are one of these guys in this heavy tank, what you should be trying to do is try to protect me, which has a very little HP, and trying to help you out by capping instead of leaving me out there. You know, if we get bum rushed by light tanks or medium tanks, I'm the first one that's going to die. But anyway, let's talk about the statistics on episode 6 compared to episode 5. In episode 6, I have played so far 41 games, 22 defensive games and 19 attack games. Oh my god, the defensive teams have only won 26% of the time. Now, remember in episode 5, defensive teams actually won 43% of the time, which is pretty good compared to episode 4. Episode 4 was also 29% of the time win rate for defensive teams. And in episode 5, when they changed around the combat reserves, they moved it around from the light tanks into the heavy tanks. Heavy tanks got 3 reserves. Medium tanks got 2 combat reserves, and light tanks only 1 combat reserve. This helped out episode 5 a lot, and because of that, defensive teams have won a lot more, 43% of the time, which is really good. It means the games were balanced out a lot better. Attacking teams only won 57% of the times in the games that I played anyway. In my 72 game sample, I felt that defensive teams won a fair amount of time, so that was really good. But however, in episode 6, in my 41 games, defense teams only won 26% of the time. Now, let me get back to the stats again. Let's go back into the game again before I continue with the stats. Right now, I am rushing forward to the objective 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm rushing forward to YOLO to die, basically, because I have already captured Alpha and I have already captured Delta. So I'm going forward right now, going towards the guns. I'm not actually trying to shoot the guns. In the 2 years that I've been playing this frontline modes, 2018 and 2019, episode 1 to episode 6, I have almost never shot the guns. I've almost never shot objective 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've always left it to the rest of my team to shoot the guns because I am not in a hurry to finish the game. I want to do damage and I want to rank myself up to general before I want the game to be over. I'm taking a shot at the guns because there literally is nothing else to shoot at. And so I see a T-44 rushing in, so I'm going to shoot this T-44, try to 1v1 him if I can. And I'm prepared to die because I have 2 tanks in reserve. And what you don't see me doing is toggling a lot of the team sheet and the map. And I'm very well aware of the map. Alpha has been capped, Bravo has been capped, Delta and Echo has been completely capped out. The only thing that hasn't been capped out right now is Charlie and Foxtrot, which is what made me push forward all the way to the end there, get myself killed. I have already made use of that tank. The T-44-100 has made full use of itself. What I want to do now is get into a tank and see if I can get some more capture points by capturing Charlie and Foxtrot. So that's exactly what I'm going to do, get into a light tank or maybe a heavy tank. I've chosen the FL-10 wheel tank, of course. That is a very good mobile tank to do this thing. Now back to the statistics again. Attacking teams have been winning 73% of the time in the 41 games that I've played. 73% of the time they have been winning. So it is heavily favoring attacking teams again. And also the length of time this game is being played. From the 24 minutes that was in episode 5, the average time for each game, it has now become 21.21 minutes per game. So the length of time has been shortened, and I know why, exactly why. In episode 6, everybody that's playing front lines have already been, you know, they're used to the changes they made in episode 5 with regards to the combat reserves. Like I said, in episode 5, earlier on, early in the first 1-2 days of episode 5, the defense teams were winning more than the attacking teams. But as more people got used to the attacking mode, they were coming back. By the end of episode 5, attacking teams were overwhelming the defensive teams, and now picking off where they left off in episode 5, attacking teams have just completely annihilated defensive teams. They figured out the meta. They're used to this combat reserves being on the heavy tanks. They know exactly what to do, how to play this game, and how to be maximize their efficiency. Basically just rush Bravo and rush Echo, B and E, just rush down the middle, cap out the two middle, the middle objectives, and finish off the game. Now I am toggling the team sheet and the map again. I know exactly what I'm going to do. As soon as this barrier drops, I'm going to go straight to the cap, and because I've actually figured out there's no one defending Foxtrot at the moment, so I know there's just like two RT or something. There's maybe like three tanks defending. Yeah, so I'm pointing this out to you in post game because the in-game recording actually doesn't show me toggling the team sheets and the map. Now this is the perfect position to park in your EBR or any tank, medium tank or heavy tank, because you want to side scrape against the left side and the right side. If they are shooting you from the right side behind those trees, you can kind of side scrape against them, and on the left side you can side scrape slightly against those guys, and I'm pointing them out to you there. I'm side scraping against both sides. Now I'm gonna get shot by somebody in HE. I think it is a M41. There he is. So he's far to my right side, so I need to protect myself from him. So I'm gonna use this house and hide behind this house, and hopefully nobody on the left side is gonna shoot me. But basically I'm already major, and I just need to, you know, shoot a couple more guys and I will be well on my way to becoming general. So here I am already general. So what I'm gonna do is just try to maintain this, try to get myself general of the army. All I need to do is just keep doing some damage if I can. If I don't get any damage, that's okay. 1200 points already in the bag with me being general. Being general of the army is a bonus, of course. There's nothing special about it. You get an extra badge, biggest dickest, I guess. But like I said in Frontlines episode 6, I have not been enjoying myself as much. In episode 4 I played 85 games. In episode 5 I played less games, only a total of 72 games. In episode 6 I'm playing 41 games so far, and I'll probably end up playing another 20, so maybe another 60 games. Why I'm playing less games, I'm not enjoying myself as much, to be honest with you. And the reason why I'm not enjoying myself so much is because it's favoring the attacking teams too much. 73% of the time attacking teams are winning and defensive teams are only winning 26% of the time. A lot of people are spawning in the defensive teams and they are actually abandoning the games. I've caught out a lot of people that have been doing that. They've completely given up being on the defensive team. Now even though this game isn't about winning and losing, some people just don't seem to understand that this game is about trying to rank up your personal ranking points and try to make yourself general, whether you're in the defensive team or attacking team. As soon as they spawn in the defensive, they're like F in the chat, F in the chat, and they abandon the game. Of course they get zero XP and they have to sit out the entire duration of that game that they abandon. Even though they abandon it, they can't like hop into another game and hop into another frontline games in different tanks. While this game is still going on, they can't get into any frontline games. So I don't understand why they are doing it, but those guys are exacerbating the problem. They are making the defense teams even more guaranteed of losing the game because they have decided not to participate, and that's the problem with the defense team right now. Now Wargaming needs to really do something to try to balance out this game mode. They need to find a way to nerf the attacking teams. I don't know, either by nerfing their combat, the combat reserves of the attacking team, or they need to limit the amount of wheeled tanks, or maybe limit the amount of light tanks that's available to the attacking teams without penalizing any of the defensive teams. They need to basically give the defense teams a little bit more of a buff to give them a chance to at least bring the win rate to closer to the 50% mark, because right now it is just unacceptable. It is just not fun at all. As soon as you are in a defense team, you know that your chances of winning is basically 26% chances of winning. But although this game is about ranking up and trying to rank yourself up to general, a lot of people still think winning is a big part of this game. They want to win, and if you don't feel like you have a chance of winning in this game mode, you really get deflated, demoralized, and you just basically have no mood to play this game mode. You know what I mean? And to be honest with you, I have been spawning in the defensive side more than the attacking side. 22 of my 41 games have been on the defensive side, which means I've been losing a lot because I've been on this defensive side a lot. But I've been trying to make the most out of my situation. If I rank up to general, that's fine. If I rank up to captain, that's fine too. I am actually playing this game mode to earn credits because I'm already caught up. I don't need to shoot a lot of premium shells to make myself rank up to major and general as often as I can. I don't really care because I'm already caught up. I don't really need to catch up. So I'm just shooting mostly standard ammunition. So if I make general, it's a bonus. If I am captain or major, that's fine too. I don't pressure myself a lot. Now you see me being very aggressive during this end game. Well, that's because I'm already general. I don't really need to, you know, conserve my health or conserve my tank. I have two tanks in reserve. And it's almost the end of the game already, so I can just YOLO and be aggressive and try to stretch out my luck for as far as I can. If I die, I die, that's fine. I have two more tanks in reserve. If I survive, that's fine too. I can go top up my HP, and you can see why it is very frustrating if you're on a defensive side and you're facing someone like me. I've got nothing to lose. I'm in an EBR driving around and just YOLOing and making a nuisance of myself. I don't care if I die. I've already made it to general. So I can see why this is like really frustrating to the defensive players. For me, I'm having a good time because I've already made it to general. If you haven't made it to general, that's your problem. Now, again, to play this game successfully and try to rank yourself up as much as possible, you really need to balance out your tank selection, your map awareness, how aggressive you need to be. You need to be fairly aggressive playing in this mode, whether you're defending or you're attacking, in order to have a high success rate to rank up major or general, or at least try to average captain or major. You really need to be play as aggressively as possible while trying to balance out how much HP you have and how much how many reserve tanks you have. Like right now, even if I lose this Lynx 6x6, I still have another tank in reserve, so I can be completely like YOLO aggressive. If I die, that's fine. I'm just gonna try to be as aggressive as possible. It's okay if I lose this tank because I have another one in reserve, and of course I've also made it all the way to general, so I have got nothing to lose at all. Try to get another kill here, auto aim, use HE, and I've done it. Got another kill for free there, and just drive around and make a nuisance of myself. And basically this is already the end of the game for me. If the game ends right now, it doesn't matter because I've already accomplished what I want to accomplish. Now, once again, like I said, if you are in this game mode and in the attacking side, you don't really want to yes, you want to rush and try to cap as quickly as possible, but it's also in your interest for this, for you to play this game and try to prolong it beyond beyond 20 minutes. If this game ends up being 15, 18 minutes, it's not going to be good for anyone because not many people are going to make it to general. In fact, I have a lot of games that are 15 minutes, 13 minutes, 16 minutes long, where nobody on the team even made it to major. Can you believe that? These games were so fast that nobody even managed to rank up. And that's not good for anyone. So if you are on the attacking team, you want to attack and cap as quickly as possible, but it is also in your interest not to destroy the objective 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 so quickly. You want to extend this game up to 25 minutes if you can, so that more people, not just you, more people on your team, more people on the enemy team can benefit and rank up to general. And the longer the game extends, the more opportunity it is for everyone to rank up to major or general and benefit more from this XP that you can get. So there you go, general of the army for me. I'm the only general in for both teams, I think. I'm not sure. But definitely for my team, I'm the only general, so that automatically makes me general of the army, I guess. But there you go, that's what's wrong with Frontlines. I hope they make some changes to it and try to nerf the attacking side at least for episode 7. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye bye.